Fordham University Rams took the Jack Coffey Field tonight for their nationally televised game with defending Patriot League champions Lafayette College, looking to stay perfect in league play this year. And the Rams played well on both sides of the ball in a 42-18 win over the Leopards. The Fordham defense was the key to the game, holding Lafayette to just 68 net rushing yards and 258 total yards of offense. After Lafayette took a 3-0 lead, Fordham came right back, with Chase Edmonds breaking through the line and scoring from 44 yards out to give the Rams a 7-3 lead late in the first. Edmonds gained 44 of his game-high 178 yards on the play. A 36-yard Michael Morando field goal made it a 10-7 game for the Rams, who then scored again when Sam Majala hauled in an 8-yard scoring strike from Mike Niebrick with 5:37 left in the half. The Rams then executed an onside kick with Jordan Chapman tipping the ball to a teammate who recovered for Fordham. 3 plays later, Niebrick connected with Tabucky Jones Jr., with Jones making some SportsCenter top 10 moves to find the end zone for a 24-3 Fordham lead. The Rams weren't done scoring in the half, as on their next possession, Niebrick and Brian Wetzel got together with a 58-yard scoring play to up the lead for Fordham to 31-3. The defense came out strong to start the second half, with Brett Biestick recording one of his 4 sacks on the night. The Leopards scored just before the break, but the Rams answered midway through the third with a 22-yard Michael Morando field goal to make it a 34-10 game. Lafayette scored late in the third before Edmonds capped an 8-play 80-yard drive with an 8-yard touchdown run midway through the fourth. And for good measure, he threw the 2-point conversion pass to Dan Light as the Rams took a commanding 42-18 lead.
That ball touchdown was a spark. We were sputtering there for the first couple of drives. They're a very good defense. I'm not sure what the rankings were. I believe they were top 10. Chase split that inside zone there for a touchdown, and we got a roll from there. But it was certainly the spark that we needed offensively to get us going.
Another good performance by the offense. Once they got it going, they looked good. But again, the defense at key points tonight. Kept you in the game early, made some big stops throughout. So is that something that oftentimes from the outside maybe gets overlooked, and the defense has played pretty well, especially in the wins?
No, our defense has played fantastic for the past 4 weeks. You're talking about 7 points, 7 points, 16 and 18. If we could keep the opposition under 20 with the ability we have to put points on the board, it's going to make us give us an opportunity to win on a weekly basis. Stopping this running back on the ground was no small feat. I'm not sure how many yards he ended up having, but this kid's an NFL caliber running back, and they do a great job. It was a Herculean task. The kid really stepped up to the challenge.
It seemed like the momentum switched a little bit in the third quarter.
It did.
Anything that you can pinpoint went wrong there?
We had a drive go down there, and we fizzled out and had to settle for 3 points. And they're good offense, and they got the ball rolling a little bit, completed some passes and moved the ball, and it became a 2-score game there. And Michael was talking to the offense there on the sideline, saying we needed to drive down the field to get a score. We did. Converted a big pass play to Brian on a 0 blitz. That was the key to get that last score in there.
What made the onside kick feel like the right thing at that moment? It seemed like you're winning, and then it kind of wins more from there.
That was completely, Coach Susky, our special teams coordinator, throughout the week said, that they have a certain look we call kick pass, where, if they're the widest guy to that side is forward aggressively, the opportunity is there to pop that thing up and get an extra position. So he said on the third, kickoff of the game, they'd like to try it. He said it was there. So we rolled the dice and, paid off.
Again, you were able to spread the ball around tonight. I mean, how much confidence does that give you that you have guys that you can throw the ball to and a number of targets out there?
Well, it's huge as a quarterback, knowing that you have really 5 guys that you can potentially get the ball to every single play. have full confidence in him. So, you know, having the weapons we have on offense is just an absolutely terrible thing as a quarterback to have, because you know that anybody, whoever gets the ball, is going to make a play for you, and you know, you don't have to try and force it to one of your big playmakers if you really only have one or two. So, you know, it's just a great luxury to have.
Mike, seemed like for the first few games of the year, you had your ups and downs, but it seems like for the past month, things have both been clicking. What's been the biggest difference between now and the first couple of games of the year?
I think the biggest difference is my preparation. I've been putting, you know, ever since I think it was really filling over game, I've been putting, you know, a lot of hours in, like, a lot of extra film work and mechanical stuff, you know, during practice that I kind of got away from at the beginning of the year there. So. You know, Coach Bryan's done a great job of really kind of breaking down what I was doing in those first few games and helping me improve it. So I think that's kind of just what you can see in the last couple of years.
What was this night like for you, going here for you guys as players, national game, you know, obviously the defending champs on the other side of that?
Well, I know for me, it was a personal game because, you know, they ruined our perfect year last year in a game that I didn't play. So, you know, that was a personal game for me. But I know for the rest of the guys, it was just a big game, you know, emotionally, with them ruining our perfect year. So, you know, it was a game we really wanted, and I thought we really went out there and took it.
Brett, just talk about your night. There were a lot of big plays that you made, a lot of big plays defensively. Just how do you feel you did out there?
I mean, obviously tonight, the whole defense really had a great night. And the past couple weeks, I haven't made too many plays, but I was doing, from what the coaches said, a good job with the scheme, and then today with the stunts we were running inside, and the plays came. The coaches said, "Don't worry, you're not making plays, but you will if you do part of the scheme." And today I made a couple plays, and it really helped. I thought the momentum of the game turned with some of the plays.
Cool.
Thanks, guys. Thank you, guys.